Hello everybody, good afternoon, good morning, and good evening, wherever you might be seeing this video from. Today, in my kitchen, I want to be showing us how to prepare banga soup. Banga soup is this palm kernel paste. So here is the extracted paste from the palm kernel, and let me show us everything. Here is my scotch bonnet pepper, hot pepper. Here is my boiled stockfish, and here is my fresh mock crayfish, and here is my chicken, the hard chicken. I've already parboiled it, and here is a cow beef. As you can see, it's already boiled, and here is the palm kernel paste. I've already extracted it from the seed, and here are the other ingredients I will be adding. Here is the dry leaf for banga. You normally find this in Edo states or Delta states. Here is the leaf you use in preparing banga soup, and here is also roots. It's funny. In seeing it is very funny. You add this to the pot after the food you might have finished. You remove it from the soup. It gives it a perfect taste and the aroma of banga. Then here are other ingredients I will be adding. Here is my blended crayfish, and here is the banga spice, the brownish one, and here is the other banga spice, the milk color of it. So I will be adding all these ingredients today to prepare this my banga paste. Lastly, I want to show us my live catfish that I bought. If you don't have the fresh catfish, you can use the smoked catfish also. So here is our catfish. I just bought this I'm about to clean it with warm water, with hot water. As you can see, it's very, very fresh. I have cleaned it. You see, it's still even moving. It's still moving. So I am about to add my, if I'm using a fresh fish like this, I like washing it with hot water. And I think this plastic is too small for it. Let me put it inside. Okay. So as you have seen it, I have already cleaned all the rough parts of the fish, both the inner parts. As you can see, I have removed everything. The only thing that is remaining now is to add a warm hot water to clean it thoroughly. As you can see, that is the hot water, so I'll just add the hot water to it. Oh, the fish is still much alive. Oh, I have to be very careful. Oh, you see? So if you want to eat a very good, you see, when you add hot water to your fish, you see all these whitish substances will be just be pulling off. You see? It's just pulling off by itself, you see? So if you don't know this secret, you'll know it today. So after adding the hot water to it, I'll now use my iron sponge. You see? You see, as it's removing it, the fish is still moving. Oh, God help me. So let me allow it to rest a bit before I clean it up. You see, this is just the secret. Some people, they'll just buy catfish and just wash it like that and put it in the pot. All this whitish substance, you see, if you don't wash it thoroughly, you eat rubbish. So let me clean it very well, thoroughly, before I will start my cooking. Alright guys, you see that beautiful black looking catfish? I've already cleaned it. You see how pretty it looks? So those blackish stuff you are seeing is dead. So I've cleaned it now, so I'll have to cut it to the sizes I want. You see, that is my catfish. Alright my people, so here are the ingredients I will be using for my banga. My boiled chicken, this hard chicken, and here is the stockfish already parboiled, and here is the catfish. fresh catfish already washed also. Here's the banga leaf, and here's my crayfish, and here's the banga spice, in stem, and my seasoning cube, my more crayfish, beef meat already boiled. Here's the pepper, fresh blended pepper, and here is my banga paste. Wow. So let's get starting. We place first the pot. I place the pot, then I will now add the stock, the meat stock, the one I extracted from the boiled meat and chicken. Sorry guys, the whole stock I extracted from the boiled meat, the chicken, stock fish and everything. That is it. Sorry my people, I just got distracted by call that came into my phone. So that is the stock. So firstly, I'm going to add this stem, this banga stem, direct. It will be inside the pot. When I finish cooking, I will still remove it. So right away, I'm adding all the meat, the cow beef, the stock fish. Banga soup is very easy to cook, very easy to cook. Not to talk of this one that then the chicken, as you see, I'm adding everything, the chicken and the banga spice, straight away, my crayfish. I'm too generous with crayfish. Then I'll have to add the pepper. Now, my fresh pepper, as you see. That is my hot crushed bonnets. Yes. Then, my seasoning cubes. As you can see. Then, after adding the seasoning cube, I'm adding the banga leaf. I've washed it. It's always like this. Banga leaf. Then I will now add the banga paste. That is my palm kernel paste. So I'm adding it right away. As you can see, you see? See? That is it. Then I will have to stir it before I add my fish. Everything at a time. After you have already parboiled, you can add everything at a time, then you leave to start cooking. So after I've stirred it now, what I'm going to do right away is to add my fish and cover to cook. Here is my mockery. After adding my mockery, I will have to stir it gently. Then I will have to add my catfish gently. Wella, that is the head, ebano. That is the head, this middle. As you see, is what I am adding lastly. Then I will now cover it to cook. So I cover to cook now. So everything is in there. In few minutes our banga soup will be ready.